Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Erica. I have a fun tutorial for you today. We are going to be making this really cute Dresden plate zipper pouch. It's fully lined, no raw seams, and super easy. So let's go ahead and get started.
So for this project, we're going to need some batting. We're going to need some kind of fabric for the base of your bag. You're also going to need a selection of print colors for the Dresdens. And I'm just using these little 5-inch squares because that's the size I want. You're welcome to cut them out of scraps or whatever else you have. You're going to need a zipper and then just your basic sewing supplies. And then also I am using this Dresden ruler. You can use any Dresden ruler you want. This one is the Pie Ruler by Lori Holt, but really you can use any one that you have on hand. Let's go ahead and get started. So to cut these Dresdens, and I usually cut more than one to just save myself some time. So I'll layer like maybe two or three fabrics on top of here. Just get them nice and lined up. Then we're going to take our Dresden ruler, and with the skinny end, I'm going to just line it up with my 5-inch mark right here. So that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 inches. This is a little 5-inch Dresden. We're gonna trim that off. And also that. And so we've got one little set there. Then we're gonna flip our ruler over and just following this line, do another set. And then these we can just set aside for use in another project. And there we have several of our little Dresden pieces, like so. All right, so you can get two pieces out of every 5-inch square if you're making it the same size as I am. So we need a total of 16 of these little pieces. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish cutting out some more colors, and then I'll meet you back here. So here is our pile of little Dresdens here, and next we're going to take these and fold them in half, right sides together, with this wide edge together like this, and we're just going to sew 1/4 inch right down that line. And what I'll do is just pile these over my machine and just sew them through one after the other, chain stitching them. That way we can knock out quite a few of these in very little time. Here they all are, and all we need to do now is cut them apart, and I'm going to just use my little caddy here. If you're curious, I've got this in one of my boxes. I'll try and link it below. Okay. Now, all we have to do is take these little guys and just pop this out like so. And I like to use my Hera marker. It helps mark quilt lines, and then it has this pointy edge on this side. And then we're just gonna take that over to the ironing board and just press that so we have a nice crease. And then it will look like this, and we need to do that on every single one of these guys. Okay, so I've just taken my little Dresden pieces here, and I've just laid them out in a way that I think looks good. And I like to keep them 4 kind of together. It's a little bit more manageable in my opinion. But basically what we're going to do is sew each one of these little quadrants together. So we're gonna take our first piece and lay it onto our next piece. And we're just gonna sew right down this edge using 1/4 inch. And then we'll press that open, and then we'll add this piece and this piece and so on. And I'm gonna do that until I have all 4 quadrants completed. So here are my 4 panels sewn together, and then all I need to do are sew these 2 together and these 2 together, and then sew them both together. And here is our finished Dresden. Isn't it so cute? Now, don't worry, we've got an opening here. We're gonna cover that up with a little bit of fabric so you won't see any of those raw edges. All right, now for the center, I've just cut out a little piece here that's 2.5 inches wide by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 5.5 inches. And then we're going to take that and place it right sides together like so. And then I'm just going to take this little circle that I have here, and I'll have a template in your pattern as well. This is a 2-inch circle. Of course, you could make yours whatever size you want. And then we're going to take this over to the sewing machine, and I'm going to sew all the way around this circle. All right, so now I've sewn all the way around the outside of my circle. And then I'm just going to kind of pull these layers apart just a little bit to make sure that I don't have that bottom layer. You can kind of put this little snip in here before you start to. Sometimes that's a little bit easier. I forgot. And then I'm just going to snip. Okay, and I'm just going to cut enough that we can turn this little circle right side out. And then I'm also going to take my scissors here and just trim around that line. Don't go into your stitch line, just be close to it. There we go. All right, and then we can turn our little piece right side out. Now we're just going to turn it right side out. And I'm going to get out my little hair marker here because this is probably one of my favorite tools. And then I just kind of gently nudge it along that seam line. Helps kind of smooth any points out. And then once I get it to where I like it, I'm going to take it over to the ironing board and just press it into a nice little circle. All right, now we are ready to start working on the outside of the bag. And so I'm just going to take my piece of canvas here, and this is 15.5 inches by 15.5 inches. You don't need it quite that large. I just like to give myself a little extra room whenever I'm working with Dresdens, just because it makes me feel a little bit more comfortable on centering and things like that. So all I'm going to do is just center my Dresden on my fabric like this, and then I'm going to use some pins and just pin it into place. And then we're going to take it over to our sewing machine, and we're going to sew all along the tops of these guys. You could also spray base this on as well. That might work better. All the way around to attach the Dresden, and then when you're done with that, you're going to take your little circle and sew all the way around that as well. Alright, so here is my Dresden. It's all nice and put onto my canvas backing here. And then we're going to just trim this up. And then I like to put 1.5 inches on all sides of my Dresden for this step. And so if you'll notice, I'm kind of lining up my ruler along one of these lines and then one of these lines. And theoretically, everything should line up properly. And then I'm going to go ahead and just cut off that side. And this one's at 1.5, so I'll cut off that side. And then I'm going to rotate this around so I can do the other two. So here's our finished Dresden. And then I'm going to take my batting. And you could also use fusible fleece if you want. And I'm just going to place that on there, and then I'm going to probably just spray baste it, and then I'm going to run another set of stitches around the outside of this just to adhere the outside to the batting. Also, I think it'll just really make that Dresden shape pop. So I decided that my machine stitching didn't quite pop enough, and so I went ahead and just dug through my stash and found some floss that matched my fabric. And I'm sorry, I can't tell you what color this floss is because I literally, it wasn't labeled and I literally just dug it out of my stash. But I decided to just do some little hand quilting stitches around the outside of my Dresden. I think it makes it look a lot cuter than the machine stitching. And so I figured I would kind of show you how I do that. I tied a knot on the end of my thread, and then these are, I'm using 3 strands of floss. It comes in 6 strands, so I divide it in half. My other half is sitting over here ready to be used. And so I tied a knot, and you can see that knot right here. I just pulled it through the back so you won't be able to see it. It'll be inside the bag. And then now we're down here on this bottom. I've kind of made it about halfway around. And so all I'm doing here is just putting my needle in, and then right back up, I'm taking just a small little bite out of it, nothing major. And I am using these little dots, polka dots if you haven't. I'm not a huge thimble type person, but I do like these little sticky dots because they stay on pretty well, and then I don't have some big clunky thimble. And that's all I'm doing, all the way around. And I just use that dot to push my needle through. And I just almost pulled it off, but I figured I'd show you anyways. A little trick on threading your needle is if you lay the thread over the needle and then kind of just pull it through like that, it kind of helps crease it. And then I keep that crease pinched in my fingers, hopefully you can see it, and then just push it through that way. And then I'm just going to go ahead and continue taking small little stitches here. Done, and I just did a cute little hand stitch all the way around this, and it's super cute. And next thing we're gonna do is start adding our zipper. So I'm gonna take my zipper and place it right side down. Right side is the side with the little zipper pull here, and I'm gonna place it right side down on the top edge of my bag. And I just kind of centered my zipper here, so we're gonna place that right side down, and then we're gonna take our lining fabric and we're going to place that right side down on top of the zipper. And then we're going to take this over to our machine and run a stitch right along this edge, getting as close to our zipper teeth as possible. If you have a zipper foot for your machine, I suggest using it. If not, like me, I'm just going to go ahead and use my regular foot and just get as close to those teeth as I can. When I come up to my zipper pull, I'm going to lift up my presser foot, pull my zipper pull out of the way, and then keep going, and you'll see that as we go through the video. All right, so here is what it should be looking like. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take this over to my ironing board and press it down, and then I'm gonna run a top stitch right along here. That will help keep everything in place, and then I'll meet you back here. All right, we're basically gonna repeat the same process. We just have to do it a little bit differently because we have one solid piece instead of two like normal. So again, we're gonna have our Dresden facing up, and then we're gonna take the other half of our bag, which is our zipper right side, and place that down on top of it. And just line those up nicely. And then I'm just gonna throw a couple of Wonder Clips on just to keep it in place. And then we're gonna take the other piece of our lining and lay that on top, right side down as well. And then we can just clip all 3 layers in place. And again, take that over to the machine and sew along this edge. All right, now we have this kind of a wonky looking thing going on here. And then to do the stitching along this, I basically pull this zipper back as far as I can and get as close as I can to it, stitch it down, and then come back and just stitch right here. And that's just probably the easiest way to do that. Okay, now we're going to leave our zipper open. We're gonna need that open so we can turn our bag. And we're going to line this up so that we've got our lining pieces together, and the outside of our bag is folded in half together. Then we're gonna take this to the machine and we're gonna run a stitch along all these edges and down to here, and leave about, I don't know, 5 or so inches open down here from here to here so that you can turn your bag right side out. You also, like I mentioned, want to make sure that your zipper is unzipped as well. You will need to be able to turn this whole thing inside out or right side out. And then just one little tip here. The zipper teeth are kind of naturally pointing towards the lining. I like to go ahead and let them stay facing that way because once you get to these, you will be kind of folding this side in half. Just make sure that you're careful and you don't hit this little bit of metal with your needle. I'm gonna be in here about, I would say, a quarter to a half an inch seam allowance all the way around this. So you should be okay. Hopefully your zipper's a little bit larger than mine. So here we have this, and now this will be a good time to just trim off any of excess from your zipper. Get that out of the way. And then we can go ahead and pull our bag right side out. You could box the corners of this one if you wanted. I would just suggest maybe like a little 1.5 inch box bottom. Since this is such a small pouch, I'm not actually going to do that. All right, our last step is to close up this opening. So I'm just going to kind of finger press in these edges right here, about 1/4 inch. Take that over to my machine and just close that up. There we go. Just fold your lining into your bag. Make sure everything's nice and tidy. And we have a cute little Dresden zipper bag.
All right guys, that is it for my super easy Dresden zipper pouch. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I think this pouch would be perfect for pretty much any kind of sewing or crafting supplies. It would even be a fun pencil case for school, but definitely you could put knitting needles, crochet hooks, stitching supplies, any kind of sewing supplies you need as well, and have a really cute travel bag for those. So thank you so much for joining me for today's video. If you liked it, please make sure to thumbs up and subscribe. That way I know to keep making these videos for you. Thanks so much for joining me today, and I will see you next time.